In this demo, I will give you a short introduction to the BioNumerics Cluster Analysis module. The database we will use contains a set of bacterial strains that are characterized by a number of techniques. The left panel contains a list of the database entries, which are the bacterial strains, and as you can see, they are characterized by a number of information fields. Before we create a cluster analysis, we will have to make a selection of the entries we want to cluster. This we can do manually by selecting entries one by one, holding down the Ctrl key. Or by selecting a range of entries using the Shift key. But for larger databases, we often want to select entries based on a search or query. I push this button to find entries in the list. And I enter Bordetella. I press Select All. We see that all entries are now marked with a flag on the left. These entries are selected. To cluster entries, we open the comparison window to create a new comparison. All entries that are selected in the database will automatically be loaded in a new comparison. Within the main window, there is a comparisons panel. This panel contains all saved comparisons for the current database. We open a comparison window by pressing the green cross button to create a new comparison. The comparison window is the basis for most of the comparative functions of the software, including cluster analysis, PCA, classification and identification, sequence alignment, and so on. It is one of the most important windows in BioNumerics. The panel information fields displays the names for the selected entries. Optionally, we can also show the images or quantitative data for one or more experiments. The experiments defined in this database are displayed in the upper left panel, the Experiments panel. For example, I will display the pulsed field gel electrophoresis images next to the entries. To do so, I click on the display icon left from the experiment name. Horizontal and vertical zoom sliders allow me to have a better overview. Optionally, you can display the densitometric curves on the fingerprints, or display the curves without the images by hiding the images. Or display the bands on the images. It is also possible to show a scale of molecular weights on the fingerprints by pressing the button to show the metric scale. Of course, the more you zoom in on the patterns, the finer the scale will be displayed. If you want to cluster and display only a specific zone on the fingerprints, you can set the active zone as follows. I press the Set Active Zones button. For example, I set the active zone between 10 and 95%. Optionally, I can hide the non-used zones, which I will do for now, and press OK to confirm the changes. Now to create a cluster analysis, I push the clustering button in the main button bar, which offers me two choices. A similarity-based clustering right within the comparison window, or a much more advanced clustering tool that includes all kinds of character-based and criterion-based methods. We will see that the mainstream clustering tool is more than comprehensive enough to cover most applications. The clustering dialog is a two-page dialog. The first page allowing us to choose which similarity or distance coefficients, and the second page the clustering algorithm. Note that the similarity coefficients shown are based on the selected experiment type. If I would have chosen to cluster sequences, the available options would be completely different. On the right side are the available options and parameters for the selected coefficient. For example, if I select Pearson correlation, I obtain different parameters than when I select the Dias coefficient. For now, I select number of different bands, which is a simple and easy to interpret distance coefficient. Note that you can define a number of additional parameters and options, such as tolerance window for band matching, the way to treat uncertain bands, how to match double band on one pattern against a single band on another pattern, a shift of patterns to obtain optimal alignment, and so on. I leave the settings like they are and I press Next. Here I am allowed to choose the clustering method. For UPGMA and related techniques, I can also calculate the standard deviation or the cofinetic correlation for every branch. Optionally, the program can also calculate the degeneracy of the tree, so that it will show me for every branch how many alternative solutions there are. Note also that I can store multiple dendrograms within a comparison, even for the same experiment if I enter a different name. I press Next and the dendrogram is calculated. If you want to learn more about the display and edit features in the comparison window, we invite you to view our other movies.